हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज चैप्टर सेकंड, दैट इज लॉजिक गेट्स एंड बुलियन अलजेब्रा।
सो टुडेज टॉपिक फॉर द वीडियो इज एसओपी एंड पियर्स रिप्रेजेंटेशंस फॉर लॉजिक एक्सप्रेशंस। टिल नाउ वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट लॉजिकल एक्सप्रेशंस एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी द एसओपी एंड पियर्स रिप्रेजेंटेशंस फॉर द लॉजिक एक्सप्रेशंस। सपोज we have a logic expression, that is y equal to ac plus bc. So we can construct the logical diagram for this expression also. So in this expression, it is a form of this expression is nothing but the form of a two terms sum, or it perform the sum of a two terms. Okay, here these two terms and the sum, this plus sign represent the sum of these two terms, and this each term is nothing but the product terms. So these two terms, they are representing the product terms. So we can say that we can represent this expression in the SOP form, that is sum of product terms. What is SOP? It is nothing but the sum of product terms. So here this AB, A and C plus B and C. So here this product and sum operations, they are not actually the product or multiplication or addition of operations. Actually they are nothing but the OR and AND operations, logical operations we are performing over that literals. So this inputs or this Y is nothing but the output. It is used to represent the output of the circuit, and this A, B and C, they are nothing but the inputs or literals. They are called as a inputs or a literals. So this SOP form can contain the number of terms, they get number of product terms, they can sum together, and each product term may contain more than one literals or a inputs. For example, here we can represent the expression in SOP form, that is ABC plus A bar BC plus A B bar C bar plus A bar C. So in this way we can represent the equation or expression in the SOP form. So this represents the sum, and this terms, they represents the product terms. So we can say that this expression is represented in SOP form. Similarly, we can represent y equal to xy plus x bar y plus x y bar. So this is also the expression in the SOP form. Again, we can represent the expressions into POS form also. POS is nothing but the product of sum. Product of sum terms. Okay, SOP is nothing but the sum of product terms, and POS is nothing but the product of a sum terms. Okay, so this is the SOP and a POS. So we can represent the POS expression as y equal to a plus b bar plus c into a plus b plus c bar into a plus b plus c. So here these terms, they are nothing but the sum terms, and we are ending this terms. So this is nothing but the product. So we can say that this is nothing but the product of sum terms. So here three terms we have used and we are ended them. So this is nothing but the POS form. So similarly we can represent the expression, or we have a different examples. So here we can represent x plus y bar into x plus y into x bar plus y. So in this way we can represent the POS expressions. So there are standard and canonical SOP and POS forms. Standard and canonical SOP and POS forms. First, understand what is standard and what is canonical SOP and POS form. So here standard forms, they are nothing but the in this equations it is not, or we can say that they are not minimized. Standard forms of equation, okay, so these equations are not minimized. That means it contains the redundant terms. Actually, we have seen in logical simplification of the logical expressions. What we have doing in simplification? Actually, in simplification, we are removing the unwanted terms or variables. That means we can minimize the expression. So the standard form of these expressions, it contains all the literals or inputs. That means it is not minimized. Okay, it is not in a minimized form. It contains all the literals or the all inputs. In the contrast, canonical forms. So this canonical form, meaning of canonical, is nothing but the conforming to a general rule. So it is conforming to the general rule, and the general rule is that is each term in a switching equation must contain all the available input variables. So each term in equation must contain all the variables. In standard form, it is not required that each term must contain all the variables. So here this is not in the minimized form, but in canonical form it must be contain all the variables in each term. So let's see the example for standard. Standard form. So we can write here y equal to ab plus abc bar plus a bar bc. So here this first term contain only two variables or literals. The second term and third term, they contain the three variables or literals. So here this is not in the minimized form, and we can say that it is in the standard form. For canonical, we can represent the equation as AB plus AB bar plus A bar B. So here, according to this canonical form equations rule, each term in equation must contain all the variables. So this first term contains all the variables. So here only two literals or two inputs are used. So first term contain the AB, second term contain the AB bar, and third will contain the A bar B. So each term contain all the variable. Or another example, we can see A bar AB bar C plus ABC bar plus ABC. So here also each term contain all the literals or variables or inputs. So this is also a canonical form of the equation. So this is nothing but the standard and canonical forms of the SOP and a POS form. Okay, similar way we can represent the POS equations in the standard and a canonical form. So we can convert this standard SOPs to the canonical SOP form, or we can convert the standard POS into canonical SOP. So let's convert this expressions. So first, convert the expression that is y equal to AB plus AC plus BC into canonical form. This is the standard equation actually. We have to convert it into canonical form. So this is the standard equation. How here actually this circuit will contain the three inputs A, B and C. So here first term missing the one literal, that is C, and second term B literal is missing, and in third term A literal or input is missing. So this is not a canonical form because each term is not containing the all inputs or literals. So we have to convert this into canonical form. So we have to first find out the missing literals. Or input. So here C is missing, here B is missing, and here A is missing. So this is our first step. Step 1, find out the missing literals. Now step 2, we have to add each term with missing literal. Okay, we have to add each term with the missing literal plus its complements also. Okay, we have to add each term. So here simplify the equation. So here for in first term C is missing, so we have to add each term with the missing literal plus its complement. So here C is missing, so we are adding this term with the missing literal and its complement. Again, we are adding the second term with the missing literal and its complement. And again, third term we are adding with the missing literal and its complement. Now, multiply this. So we get here ABC plus A, B, C bar. Again here we get A, B, C bar plus A bar, C bar plus A, B, C plus A bar, B, C. Okay, after multiplication we get these terms. So here these two terms, they are equal. and these two terms, they are equal, means similar. So according to the law, A plus A is A. So we can write this ABC plus ABC is nothing but ABC plus this ABC bar, ABC bar is nothing but single term ABC bar, and the remaining terms, that is A, B bar, C bar plus A bar, BC. So this is the canonical SOP for. Canonical SOP 4. That means each term contain all the literals or variables. Okay. So in this way we can convert the standard SOP into canonical 4. So we can also convert the standard POS into canonical 4. So let's convert. So first example we have seen for the SOP. Now the second, convert the given expression into canonical POS form. Okay. Now we have to convert this equation into canonical POS form. That is y equal to a plus b into a plus c into b plus c bar. So we have to convert this standard POS equation into canonical. Our first term is, or first step is, find the missing literals. So here C is missing, here B is missing, and here A is missing. Now the second step, what we have to do, or each term with missing literal plus its complement. Sorry. And its complement. For SOP, we have ANDed the missing literal and its complement plus its complement. And for POS, we are ORing the missing literal and its complement. So, step 3, simplify. Simplify the equation. So here, y equal to a plus b, we have to OR each term with the missing literal and its complement. So here, c and c bar. For second term, a plus c plus b into b bar. And for third term, b plus c bar plus a into a bar. So here, A plus BC is nothing but the A plus B into A plus C. So here, let's first multiply this. So we get A plus B plus C. Into a plus b plus c bar. Okay. Now for the second term, a plus c plus b into a plus c plus b bar. And for third term, we can write b plus c bar plus a into b plus c bar plus a bar. What we have to do? We have OR this product term with the each term. Okay. Now, here the terms a plus b plus c. Here again the term a plus b plus c. these two terms, they are nothing but the equal. So we can say that A into A is nothing but A. So according to this rule, we can say that this A plus B plus C into A plus B plus C is nothing but A plus B plus C. Okay. So similarly, this term A plus B plus C bar into again A plus B plus C bar is also equal. So we can write here A plus B plus C. So these two terms, they are equal. Again, these two terms, they are equal. That is A plus B plus C bar and the remaining, remaining terms, that is A plus B bar plus C and this A bar plus B plus C bar. Okay. So these terms or the equation is nothing but the canonical POS form. Okay. I will send the assignment for this topic to convert the SOP and POS forms into their canonical forms.